वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर थर्ड ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर स्टूडेंट्स टुडे आवर लेक्चर इज अबाउट मोटिवेशन व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ मोटिवेशन इन कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड मोटिवेशन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मोटिवेशन इंट्रिंसिक मोटिवेशन एक्सट्रिंसिक मोटिवेशन बट ओवर देयर वी वर स्टडीइंग मोटिवेशन फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव्स टुडे वी आर स्टडीइंग मोटिवेशन and the role of motivation in the consumer behavior or we are studying motivation from consumer behavior perspectives. So I have written a different definition of motivation over here. Motivation refers to the process that causes people to behave as they do. So motivation means that there are certain processes which makes the people to behave in certain specific way. So those processes or those factors or that force or that drive is called motivation over here. For example, I'm giving you a very simple example. One of my student Asad likes to have Samsung mobile, new brand of Samsung mobile. Salman likes to have a new brand of iPhone mobile. You see, so for this, their behavior are different. Salman behavior for one type of mobile, Asad behavior for another type of mobile. So it means that there are some factors, some forces behind their mentalities. So those forces behind their mentalities are called motivation. Motivation refers means. Motivation refers to the process that cause the people to behave as they do. Why they are behaving in a specific way? They are behaving, people are behaving differently from each other. So why they are behaving differently from each other? Because there are some processes and those processes have make them different. So those processes are called motivation or motivational forces. From psychological perspective, motivation occurs when a need is aroused that the consumer wishes to satisfy. So in previous semesters, we have studied a very famous theory of Maslow, Abraham Maslow. Need theory or Maslow hierarchy of need theory in which we have studied that Maslow says that human being is motivated when he realized a specific need. So over there we divided these needs into five different levels. Level number one, primary needs or physiological needs, food, shelter, cloth, etc. This is our basic need. Everybody is struggling hard to satisfy this level of need. Then there were safety needs. Everybody wants to be safe. Physical safety and mental safety. For this physical safety and mental safety, people are working very hard. Then it comes level number third needs. In level number third needs, we have got love and affection needs. Like we are spending a large amount of money on keeping people happy, to build relationships with different people, because it is our basic need to respect the other people, to give them love and to get love or respect in response. For this purpose, people are spending a large amount of money. They are working very hard. This was level number third need. Then there was status need. Status need, internal and external. Okay, status. People are spending large amount of money to have a specific brand of car, to live in a posh area, to make a good building or house, to wear good clothing. So why they are spending this amount of money? Because it is our good, it is our need. It is our need to show ourselves in the society. Or why you become an officer? Why you want to become a successful businessman? Why you are collecting large amount of money? Why you are using a specific brand of car? Because psychologically, mentally, it is the need of human to have some status in the society. At the same time, you are also answerable to your mind, internal, innate status. So people are working very hard to reach to this level. Then there was self-actualization. To reach to the maximum possible level of success is called self-actualization. Over there we have studied that why people are motivated. people are motivated by these different levels of needs. When one level of need is satisfied, automatically you are working very hard, you are motivated, you are becoming motivated automatically to satisfy that second level of need. So this is how this game is going on from childhood till the last day of life. Most of the people are dying in first level or second level, but still they are working very hard. Some of the people are dying in upper level, most of the people are dying in lower level, but they never hands up, they never stops. They are working hard because something is clicking up in the mind, in their mind, to work hard, to be more richer, to be more wealthier, to be more educated. So that thing that clicks in his mind, which keeps him motivated, is called need. So psychology says that when a need is clicking in your mind, it makes you motivated. There is no other way. Obviously, you will become motivated to satisfy that specific need. Otherwise, your life will be disturbed, or in some cases, there will be no life. The person will die. So, in this lecture, we have explained these two types of needs from other perspective. This need may be utilitarian or this may be hedonic. So here we have got two other types of needs, utilitarian need, another type of need is hedonic need. Utilitarian, the word utilitarian means practical, functional. We are desiring for a certain product or service because we want to achieve its practical result or functional result. I am giving you one example. For example, some people are vegetarian. They like to have veg burgers or to have vegetables, to have a specific brand of burger. Over there is no meat, there is vegetable, because they are health conscious. So because of the function of vegetables, they like to have certain food of vegetables or burger of vegetables. Means they are believing in some practical or functional result of that product. Or for example, you are going to gym or club for exercise, and you are using a specific running machine. You are using that specific running machine based on the function or results or practical results of that machine. So it means that is your utilitarian need. Then second thing is hedonic. Hedonic, a need that is based on your emotions, that is based on your mental associations. Somehow you have some mental relationship with that product. Emotions are there, attachments are there, associations are there. For example, some of our students are liking one club of football, and other students are liking another club of football. So they have realized that their specific brand of t-shirts with logo of that club is my need. Now whether it is his need or not, but based on his mentality, it has become his hedonic need, because this t-shirt with specific logo of a specific club is his, based on his emotional feelings. So this is called hedonic need. Now whether the need is utilitarian or hedonic, need is need, and need is creating a disturbing situation in the mind of the person, which we are calling tension. Every customer wants to release this tension, to get rid of this tension. That's why he purchased or planning to purchase this specific product. Now this tension we are measuring, that whether this tension is higher or this tension is lower. So the degree of this tension because of that utilitarian need or hedonic need, we are calling the degree of tension created because of specific need is called drive. Drive is the level or the extent or the degree of tension created in the mind of the consumer. When the need is utilitarian, whether or hedonic, it creates a tension in the minds of the consumer. This degree of arousal means clicking, arising, this need is arising in your mind, is called drive. In some people, in the minds of some people, this drive will be very much higher. In the minds of other people, this drive will be at lower degree. However, what is the job of the marketer? The job of the marketer is to understand its customer psychologically. How we are able to understand our customer psychologically? We are understanding our customer psychologically by identifying this drive. If it is at lower degree, you are trying to realize him that this is your basic need. This is very much important for you. Or this product can satisfy your that utilitarian need or hedonic need to boost up that drive. When you are boosting up that drive, automatically he selects your product. When he selects your product, it means that because of utilitarian, or in other words, we can say that because of utilitarian or hedonic need, there was a specific drive in his mind. And you capitalized on their drive and he selects your product. When he selects your product, it means want is created for your product. When want is created for your product, he will be arranging money to purchase your product. So you are converting this want to demand. When a want is backed by purchasing power of the customer, it means the demand is created for your product or service. Thank you very much, students. We will also discuss this motivation or motivation related topics in coming classes. Be with me. Khuda Hafiz.